Good afternoon, my dear children. Today I have come here to deal the first chapter of your supplementary book, How the Camel Got His Hump. Now this is a very interesting story, a very funny story, because this is the story about, we all know that camels, they do have humps. Now this is the story where the author has tried to explain in a very funny way how the camel got his hump that he carries on its back. Okay. Now the author of this story is Joseph Rudyard Kipling. Joseph Rudyard Kipling, he is an English poet, short story writer and a novelist. He is also a journalist, English journalist. He was born in India. And his many works are inspired about the things and themes of India. So we are going to start, and before that I want to share that many of you have seen the movie The Jungle Book. Yes, that Jungle Book story, that was also written by Joseph Rudyard Kipling. And I'm going to start the story. In the beginning of years, when the world was so new and all, and the animals were just beginning to work for man, there was a camel, and he lived in the middle of a howling desert because he did not want to work. And besides, he was a howler himself. So he ate sticks and thorns and tamarisks and milkweed and prickles, most excruciating idol, and when anybody spoke to him, he said humph, just humph and no more. So in the very beginning of the story, we can find that in the very beginning of the years, when the world was so new and well, the world was just created according to the author, and the animals were just beginning to work for men, because we know that there are so many animals who are used for the purpose of working for men, like donkey, camel, okay, dog, horses. So the animals, they just started working for men, and there was a camel. At that time there was a camel, and he lived in the middle of a howling desert. He used to live in a desert, very empty desert, because he did not want to work. Now why did the camel live in a desert, howling desert? Because there was no one, it was an empty desert, because he wanted to avoid doing any kind of work. Because other animals, they started working for man, and the camel was not ready to work for man. He was an idle creature, lazy creature. Idle means I-D-L-E, idle means you're lazy, lazy creature. So he went to a desert to live there, just to avoid any crowd and any for avoiding any kind of work, because he was a lazy creature and he didn't want to do any kind of work for anybody. So he ate sticks and thorns, as he was living in a desert, and we know that the desert animals, they have to feed themselves by eating sticks and thorns, okay, and milkweed and prickles. Those are available in the desert. And when anybody spoke to him, he even didn't want to reply. And for the reply, he just only used to say hump and no more. Not a single word more. He just used to give reply saying hump. Presently, the horse came to him on Monday morning with a saddle on his back and a bit in his mouth, and said, "Camel, oh camel, come out and trot like the rest of us." Now there came a horse, okay, on Monday morning. It was Monday morning when a horse came to him with a saddle on his back. Saddle, you know, the thing that is put on horse's back where a man sits on the horse to have a ride. Okay, with a saddle on his back and a bit in his mouth, and said, "Camel, oh camel, come out and trot like the rest of us." So the horse told the camel that he requested the camel to come out and trot. Trot is a movement of horse. So the horse asked the camel to come out and trot like them. Okay. Now, as usual, in reply, the horse replied only saying hump. We know that the camel used to say only one word as reply, and that was hump. So, normal. Bengali, the camel just replied saying, hum. And the horse went away and told the man. So the horse informed the man that the camel answered in such way, only saying, hum. Presently the dog came to him with a stick in his mouth and said, camel, O camel, come and fetch and carry like the rest of us. Next came a dog to the camel, and he also invited the camel to join with them. Okay, he came with a stick in his mouth and he also asked the camel to join them. He told that, come and fetch. Fetch means bring. Ki aao hum logo ki tarah join karo, and you also carry or bring and carry like the rest of us. Again the camel replied saying hum, and the dog went away and informed the man. So first the horse came and asked him to do some work like them, to trot like them, and he replied hum. And next came the dog, and the dog asked the camel to join them to fetch and carry things like them, but again the camel replied saying hum. Now presently the ox came to him with the yoke on his neck and said, camel, O camel, come and plow like the rest of us. Now we know that an ox is used in the work of farming in the field. So the ox came and requested the camel to join them and do the work of plowing like them. But again the situation was same. Hum, said the camel, and the ox went away and told the man. So here the ox again requested the camel to join them and do the work of plowing. Khet mein use hote hai ox, okay, plowing ke kaam mein. So the ox again invited the camel to join them in the work of plowing in the field. But again as usual the camel replied saying hum. And the ox went away and told the man. He again informed the man that the camel had only replied saying hum. At the end of the day, the man called the horse and the dog and the ox together and said, tree, oh tree, I am very sorry for you with the world so new and all. But that hum thing in the desert can't work, or he would have been here by now. So I am going to leave him alone, and you must work double time to make up for it. Now when the day was going to over, at the end of the day, the man called the three animals, the horse, the dog and the ox together, because they were the animals who were doing the work. So the man called them and he told that, I'm very sorry for you with the world so new and all, but that hum thing in the desert can't work. You are doing the work, so I'm very sorry for you that only you three are doing the work, but that hum thing means the camel who just replied saying hum, that hum thing can't work. Or he would have been here by now, so I'm going to leave him alone. That's why I'm going to, because that hump creature, he cannot work, so that's why I'm going to leave him alone. Main usko idhar chhod ke ja raha hu, and you must work double time to make up for it. And the part which he was supposed to do, and the part of work, and the work which the camel was supposed to do, as he is not doing his part of work, so now you three animals, you have to work double time to make up for the work of his part. That made the three very angry with the world so new and all, and they held a palaver and an indava and a panchayat and a powwow on the edge of the desert, and the camel came chewing on milkweed most cruciating idle and laughed at them. Then he said hump and went away again. So the three animals were very angry, and they were just discussing about their sorrow. They just called a panchayat. Okay, and so they were discussing about their sorrow, and the powwow on the edge of the desert, they were discussing how to get rid of this problem. Okay, and at that time the camel came chewing the milkweed most cruciating idle. He was showing his idleness, laziness, and he laughed at them. Then he said humph and went away again. So he was enjoying the thing that he was sitting idle, and the other three animals, they were doing extra work, they were working hard, they were working double time, because he was lazy. He was not doing his part of his work. He was not doing his own duty. That's why the other three animals were suffering, and they were making a panchayat and they were discussing their troubles and problems. And the camel came there and he enjoyed. He was taking fun of them. Jean of all deserts, said the horse. Is it right for anyone to be idle with a world so new and wall? Now the horse questioned the Jean of the desert. Jean, you know, a spirit, okay, a spirit or a ghost type of creature. So the horse asked the Jean of the desert, is it right for anyone to be idle, ideally to be lazy without doing any work and sitting idle? Certainly not, said the Jean. And the Jean replied, it is not good, it is not correct to sit idle without doing any work. Well, said the horse, there's a thing in the middle of your howling desert, and he is a howler himself, with a long neck and long legs, and he has not done a stroke of work since Monday morning. He won't trot. Now the horse complained to the Jean that in the middle of the desert there is an animal is sitting there, a creature is sitting there, and with a long neck and long legs, and he's describing the camel, saying that as there was no name at that time of any creature, he just described the camel, saying that an animal or a creature is sitting in the middle of the desert. He has a long neck and long legs, and he hasn't done a stroke of work since Monday morning. He hasn't done a stroke of work. He is just sitting idle. He won't trot. Usko trot bhi nahi karna hai. View, said the Jean, whistling. That's my camel for all the gold in Arabia. What does he say about it? Now the Jean could understand that they are describing about a camel. So he identified and he said that it's camel. Now what does he say about his idleness? He says hum, said the dog. And he won't fetch and carry. Usne sirf kaha hai hum. He has replied only hum. And he is not ready to carry. He is not ready to fetch and carry like us. Does he say anything else? Only hum. And he won't plow, said the ox. He is not ready to carry anything. He is not ready to trot like us. He is not ready to fetch and carry. He is not ready to plow. Very good, said the Jean. I'll hump him if you will kindly wait a minute. Now the Jean said that I will hump you. I'll hump him. Main usko hump karunga. I'll hump him if you will kindly wait a minute. You just wait a minute and I am doing hump to him. The Jean rolled himself up in his dust cloak and took a bearing across the desert and found the camel most cruciatingly idle, looking at his own reflection in a pool of water. So now the Jean, he just rolled in his cloak of dust. Cloak means cloak, cloak means clothes. Okay, the Jean just rolled like a cloak of dust. We all know how the Jean, they just rolls around. So he just rolls around in the cloak of dust. And he took a bearing across the desert. He just went in the middle of the desert and found the camel who was sitting idle, looking at his own reflection on shadow in a pool of water. My long and bubbling friend, said the Jean. What's this I hear of your doing no work with the world so new and all? Now the Jean tried to interact with the camel. He just asked the camel what he had heard, the complaints against him, against the camel. So he just said, my long and bubbling friend, said the Jean, what's this I hear of your doing no work? Main ye kya sun raha hu ki tum koi kaam nahi kar rahe ho with the world so new and all? Again the camel replied only saying hum. The Jean sat down with his chin in his hand and began to think a great magic while the camel looked at his own reflection in the pool of water. Now the Jean was confirmed that whatever complaint he has got was perfectly correct, because to him also, to the Jean also, the when the camel was inquired, he just replied saying hum. So he just started thinking. He was thinking about a great magic, and the camel was just, he was sitting idle and he was looking into his own reflection. He was enjoying seeing his own reflection in the pool of water, because he was having a beautiful long neck and long legs. So he was very, he was enjoying his own beauty, his own feature of his body. That's why he was looking at his own reflection in the pool water. You have given the 3 extra work ever since Monday morning, all on account of your excruciating idleness, said the Jean. And he went on thinking magics with his chin in his hand. Hump, said the camel. Whenever the Jean was trying to interact with the camel, he was trying to ask, the camel only replied saying hum. I shouldn't say that again if I were you, said the genie. You might say it once too often. Bubbles, I want you to work. The genie tried to make the camel understand that what he was doing, what the camel was doing, just sitting idle, was not the correct thing to do. That's why he tried to make him understand, but the camel was not ready to listen or hear. And the camel said hump again, but no sooner had he said it than he saw his back that he was so proud of puffing up and puffing up into a great big lolloping hump. So when he again replied saying hump, he just looked at his back. He just realized the back on which he used to take pride. He used to take pride and he used to enjoy his stature, his body, his physical look. Okay, he just realized that his back was puffing up, it was swelling, and it turned into a big hump. Do you see that? Said the genie. That's your very own hump that you have brought upon your very own self by not working. Today is Thursday, and you have done no work since Monday when the work began. Now you are going to work. So now the genie punished the camel by creating a hump on the back of the camel, because the camel used to give a reply only by saying hump. That's why as a punishment, the genie created a magic and he created a hump on the back of the camel just to punish him, just to make him realize whatever he was doing was not correct. And he told that today is Thursday. And you have not done anything since Monday, while all other friends are doing a lot of work, you are sitting idle. So today is Thursday and you are not doing anything since Monday, so now you are going to work. How can I, said the camel, with this hump on my back? Now the camel has got another excuse and he said that how can I work with this hump on my back? That is made of purpose, said the genie. All because you missed those 3 days, you will be able to work now for 3 days without eating because you can live on your hump. And don't you ever say, I never did anything for you. Come out of the desert and go to the tree and behave. Hump yourself. So when the camel tried to give an excuse that how can I work with this hump on my back, the genie replied that this hump has been made for a purpose. Because you have missed those 3 days, you have not worked those 3 days, Monday, Tuesday and Wednesday, and this is Thursday today, you will be able to work now for 3 days without eating. Now you are going to work for 3 days without having any meal, without eating, because you can live on your hump. There is no necessity of eating because you have got a hump and your hump is going to provide you the energy that you were supposed to get from food. That energy you are going to get from your hump. For that purpose your hump has been created. As you have missed the 3 days without walking, now you are going to work for 3 days without having food, without eating, because your hump is going to provide you that energy. And now come out of the desert and go to the tree and behave. And now come out of the desert and behave properly with those three animals, the horse, the dog and the ox. Hump yourself. And the camel humped himself, hump and all, and went away to join the tree. And from that day to this, the camel always wears a hump. We call it hump now, not to hurt his feelings, but he has never yet caught up with the 3 days that he missed at the beginning of the world, and he has never yet learned how to behave. And so after that, the camel joined the other three animals, the horse, the ox and the dog. And still today, he has his hump on his back and we call it hump. Just not to hurt his feelings, we don't call it hump, we call it hump. And but he has never yet caught up these 3 days. He had not yet, he is not able to made up the loss of those 3 days that he hadn't worked. So and he has never yet learned how to behave, because till now whenever he is asked anything, he just replies saying hum. Okay, so this is the story, and I hope that you have understood. This is a very interesting story. Okay, this is a funny story to hear, to learn. Okay, and I hope you have enjoyed. Thank you all for today.